In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Alleluia. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Good morning and welcome to you all, whoever you are and wherever you are. Welcome to the parish of Minehead and to our 10 o'clock Eucharist on this, the seventh Sunday of Easter, the Sunday after Ascension Day. Over the past couple of weeks, we've begun our service with a moment of meditation, and we're going to do the same again this week. Many of you will know that this week we said a final goodbye to Jane Herbert and to Edward Taylor. This week I'm going to offer this Eucharist for the repose of Jane's soul. And after the moment of spiritual communion, I will say prayers for Jane and for her family at this time of their loss. We take a moment of silence as we prepare to celebrate the great mysteries of our loving Lord. We say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. The Spirit of the Lord fills the world and knows our every word and deed. Let us then open ourselves to the Lord and confess our sins in penitence and in faith. Raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. You bring pardon and peace to the broken in heart. Christ, have mercy. You make one by your Spirit the torn and divided. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks. We praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you. Risen, ascended Lord, as we rejoice at your triumph, fill your church on earth with power and compassion, that all who are estranged by sin may find forgiveness and know your peace, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. It's a great joy to welcome Neil and Jess James to this service. Jess is a youth worker with the Exmoor Youth Project, and Jess is our preacher today. You can listen and watch her sermon in the other YouTube video, the link for which was in the email I sent to you. Neil is Jess's husband, and he is going to read the Gospel today for us. But before we hear the Gospel, we hear a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, beginning at the 6th verse. When they'd come together, they asked him, "Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel?" He replied, "It is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." When he said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going and they were gazing up towards heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, "Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up towards heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven." Then they returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they had entered the city, they went to the room upstairs where they were staying. Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas son of James. All these were constantly devoting themselves to prayer, together with certain women, including Mary, the mother of Jesus, as well as his brothers.
Today's reading is from Gospel of John, chapter 17, verse 1 to 11. Jesus prays to be glorified. After Jesus said this, he looked towards heaven and prayed, "Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, and that your Son may glorify you. For you granted him authority over all people, that he might give eternal life to all those you have given him. Now this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I have brought you glory on earth by finishing the work you gave me to do. And now, Father, glorify me in your presence with the glory that I had with you before the world began." Jesus prays for his disciples. "I have revealed you to those whom you gave me out of the world. They were yours. You gave them to me, and they obeyed your word. Now they know that everything you have given me comes from you. for I gave them the words you gave me, and they accepted them. They knew with certainty that I came from you, and they believed that you sent me. I prayed for them. I'm not praying for the world, but for those you have given me, for they are yours. All I have is yours, and all you have is mine. The glory has come to me through them. I will remain in the world no longer, but they are still in the world, and I'm coming to you. Holy Father, protect them by the power of your name, the name you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Creator God, risen Lord, send your Holy Spirit to renew this living world, that the whole creation, in its groaning and striving, may know your loving purpose and come to reflect your glory in Jesus Christ our Lord. In these difficult and trying times, let us come together in faithful prayer to offer intercessions to our loving, gracious God. We continue to pray for the world as we pursue victory over the virus, and we pray for all those engaged on the front line, treating people in hospital, care homes or at home, all doctors, nurses, clinicians, surgeons, healthcare assistants and all working inside the NHS. We pray for those now embarking on the long road of recovery, and all those working to support them through this process. Our world will pay a heavy economic price from its battle with COVID-19. So we pray for all leaders of the world, their cities and local communities, that they all be granted the wisdom and courage needed to make the correct decisions to rebuild our lives post-pandemic. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We continue to pray for the Christian Church across the world, as well as all other faiths who pray faithfully to the one true God. We pray for Archbishops Justin and John, our Bishops Peter and Ruth, all clergy and especially those from the Exmoor Deanery. We continue to pray for Father Simon and the group of retired clergy who all contribute so much to our parish life. And in our prayers, let us remember also the small management group working to keep matters in order, even though the church buildings are locked to us. We continue to pray for that day when our beautiful buildings will once again be open to us all to come together in joyful communion with our risen, gracious Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And let us remember all who are sick in body, mind or spirit, all those named on the prayer list in our three churches. Send your healing angels among all of them and relieve them of their pain and anguish. And now, in a short moment of silence, let us each offer prayers for those close to us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The pandemic has taken many people away from us, and many more have heard our Lord's call to join him at that great celebration of love at his table in heaven. Today we remember and give thanks for the peaceful repose of Jane and Edward, whose funerals took place this past week. May the souls of all the faithful departed rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Dear Lord and Father of all mankind, who sacrificed your only Son, that we may see your love for us all, we give thanks for all you have so freely given us and continue to pray to you for greater wisdom and awareness of how we will spread your love among all whom we meet on our journey. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Friends, we come to the peace. God has made us one in Christ. He has set his seal upon us, and as a pledge of what is to come, he has given the Spirit to dwell in our hearts. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. In your loving care you spread before us the table of life and give us the cup of salvation to drink. Keep us always in the fold of our Saviour and our Shepherd, your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Blessed be God for ever.
The Lord is here. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. And now we give you thanks that after he had ascended far above all heavens and was seated at the right hand of your majesty, he sent forth upon the universal church your holy and life-giving Spirit, that through his glorious power, the joy of the everlasting gospel might go forth into all the world. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, for ever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. So, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on our Bishop Peter and on all your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, our patrons Michael, Andrew, Peter, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and for ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast. Let us pray. Eternal God, giver of love and power, your Son Jesus Christ has sent us into all the world to preach the gospel of his kingdom. Confirm us in this mission and help us to live the good news that we proclaim through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You can see that I've placed a photograph on the altar of Charles and Jane on their wedding day, standing outside the magnificent west door of St Michael's Parish Church here in Minehead. So we pray for Jane and for Charles and for their family. You are worthy, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honour and power. For you have created all things, and by your will they have their being. You are worthy, O Lamb, for you were slain, and by your blood you ransomed for God saints from every tribe and language and nation. You have made them to be a kingdom and priests serving our God, and they will reign with you on earth. In silence, we pray for the repose of Jane's soul. This is the will of him that sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, and I will raise them up at the last day. Lord God, creator of all, you have made us creatures of this earth, but have also promised us a share in life eternal. According to your promises, may all who have died in the peace of Christ come with your saints to the joys of your kingdom, where there will be neither sorrow nor pain, but life everlasting. Alleluia. Amen. Grant to us, Lord God, to trust you not for ourselves alone, but for those also whom we love, and who are hidden from us by the shadow of death, that as we believe your power to have raised our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead, so may we trust your love to give eternal life to all who believe in him, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who's alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. Amen. May Jane, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. From Ascension to Pentecost, our archbishops ask us to pray three very important words, three words that actually I believe are very dangerous words, because if we pray these words and we mean them, then God will do what only God can do. And those three words are, of course, thy kingdom come. Can I encourage you to do one thing over these days? Can you think of three people whom you love, who perhaps have not yet recognised their need for the love of God in their hearts and their lives? Put their names on a post-it note or on pieces of paper, and put those post-it notes or those pieces of paper by your kettle. And then every time you go to make a cup of tea, hold those three people up to God's throne of grace, and pray, thy kingdom come. And let God do what God does. The Lord be with you. The Spirit of truth lead you into all truth, give you grace to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and strengthen you to proclaim the word and the works of God. And the blessing of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you and those that you love and pray and care for this day and always. Amen. Christ has gone up on high. Alleluia. God raised Jesus Christ from the dead and enthroned him at his right hand in the heavenly realms. God put all things in subjection beneath his feet and gave him as head over all things to the church. We died and our life lies hidden with Christ in God. We set our minds on things above. When Christ, who is our life, is revealed, we too will be revealed with him in glory. The Eucharist has ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.